In the previous chapter, we developed the servo and regulator transfer functions for a standard feedback control loop, and we saw how we can use these mathematical descriptions to establish stability limits for feedback controllers. Feedback controller design involves more than just choosing among P, PI, PID controllers, and then choosing the sign of the controller gain to ensure stability. When designing feedback controllers, what we want to do is choose specific values for the gain, the reset time, and the derivative time. We call choosing these values controller tuning, and we can tune feedback controllers based on how we want the feedback control loop to respond to set point changes and disturbance inputs. For example, consider a step disturbance for an FOPTD process with a PI controller. The responses to a unit step disturbance input for a process with this transfer function and 9 different PI controllers are shown here. Depending on how we choose the controller tuning parameters, that is, how we tune the controller, we can obtain responses to disturbance inputs that are unstable, that lead to very slowly decaying oscillations, or that result in a deviation of the controlled variable that takes a long time to settle down, or we can choose tuning parameters that result in much more reasonable responses, like case 5 shown here. There really is an infinite number of combinations of the tuning parameters that will lead to stable behavior. However, not all of these would be optimal for a particular process. In this chapter, we'll introduce methods for tuning PID controllers that are based on criteria for how we want the feedback control loop to respond to inputs. First, let's talk about those criteria. How do we want the feedback control loop to behave? First and foremost, the closed loop system must be stable. That is, the output must be bounded for any bounded input. Next, we might want to tune the controller so that it obtains good disturbance rejection and set point tracking. That is, when a disturbance variable is perturbed, we want to minimize the resulting perturbations in the output variable, and when the set point is changed, we want the output variable to go to the new set point. We may want to tune a feedback controller so as to eliminate steady state offset. Alternatively, we might choose to avoid excessive controller action, meaning that when there's a disturbance or set point input, we don't want the controller to keep changing the manipulated variable for a long time or cause oscillations in the manipulated variable. Often we want to tune controllers for robustness. Robustness refers to how sensitive the feedback control loop is to changes in process conditions and model inaccuracies. A robust feedback control loop has low sensitivity to such changes. That is, it can tolerate variations in the operating conditions. Now, it may be that all of these objectives cannot be achieved simultaneously. For example, if we want to eliminate steady state offset, we may need to include an integral element in our PID controller. And the integral element will introduce additional controller action because the integrating element of a PID controller continuously changes the output until the error signal goes to zero. Similarly, very tight control, that is, obtaining excellent disturbance rejection and set point tracking, may result in controller tuning parameters that are not very robust or that cannot tolerate changes to the operating conditions without becoming unstable. Good disturbance rejection and set point tracking may require that we tune a controller very close to a stability limit. In this chapter, we'll introduce several controller tuning methods. The first is called the direct synthesis method, and then we'll modify the direct synthesis method to generalize it into what we call the internal model control method. Next, we'll introduce several types of controller tuning relations, and in a later chapter, we'll look at controller tuning methods based on the frequency response of feedback control loops. Of course, computer simulation is an important tool for controller tuning, and we'll show how to use Simulink, which will enable us to easily model multiple alternative sets of tuning parameters for the same controller and select the ideal one. Finally, we'll talk about online tuning. In the next video, we'll introduce the direct synthesis method.